Hello everybody, it's Mr. Second Amendment, and I wanted to do an update video and also kind of a preview of what I'm trying to do, what's to come. Work has been crazy, and there's no end in sight on that. So I wanted to give you guys some updates on the projects you guys have seen, been asking about, that unfortunately I haven't been able to do full-length videos on yet. So I got reminders sitting around the table here. So first of all, recent new purchase here is Glock 26 Gen 4. I've shot these in the past. All the guns that I carry or use are all full-size guns. As a bigger guy, I can get away with that, concealing that. So I've never really been interested in or messed with any subcompacts. But the deal was too good to pass up, so I went for it. Definitely enjoy the fact so far that the accuracy for me is surprisingly good considering the short sight radius, and especially with my hand size, the grip issues here. So with the factory mags, I know you can get the grip panels that change out on the floor plate there. Definitely going to be a future thing. But I love the fact that they work with the standard 19 mags. They even work with the 19X mags. And even if you want to get crazy with it, with the Glock 21, or the, excuse me, the Magpul 21 round mags. So after I get enough time on the system, do a little bit more shooting, get some data, I do intend on doing a full review of Glock 26, at least the Gen 4. So that's kind of new what's going on there. Another video I've been planning for a while, just haven't had time, is the Ruger SR22 video. And I love this gun because it has a horrible trigger and it has a horrific reset. And you guys know I'm kind of a trigger and reset snob. It also has exposed hammer, double single action. So the bottom line here is this is great for training, especially if you got a Beretta or like a SIG 226 or something like that. Great recreational, but I use it as a training gun because if you can master what is the craziness that's happening on this gun, if you can work with this trigger, you can work with basically anything. And it's low cost training. So that's why I love this gun. Sights are adjustable. I've been having a lot of fun with it. It's been pretty awesome. So I've had this for a couple years now. I think I have enough data on it to give you an honest review. Actually pretty accurate too, if you feed it what it likes. I got my Model 19 Classic here because I do intend on doing a wheel gun reload video with the different ways that you can reload a wheel gun. So for those who don't know, Smith & Wesson came out with the Model 19 again. They call it the Model 19 Classic. It's the 19-9. Some of you may love it, some of you may hate it, but I got some videos on it. Not going to get too detailed here, but at least for me, this is old school cool and I love it. Of course, that's your 357 Magnum. Old school Bill Jordan brainchild here with Smith & Wesson. Love this gun. Next reminder I have on the table is I have been planning a review on this Kimber 22 conversion slide for a 1911. And I actually have had a lot of success with this on the various 1911s that I've put it on and trained with. It's got target style Bomar sights. What I love about it is they kept the 45 barrel profile, but they basically just turned it into a bowl barrel. And this thing was precision made. I don't know how they are these days because I got this, I think, sometime in 2012. So I've had this thing for like 7 years. I've shot the heck out of it and I just love it. It's a great training tool, just a great, you can turn any 45 1911 into your, well, not any, but just about any standard 45 1911 into a 22. So I do intend on doing a review. Let me know if you got any interest in that. Next, we got the 1911 from the 1911 Rebuild Project series that I've been slowly working on. Just have not had a lot of time to properly dedicate some time to actually put the changes into the gun that I want to do. I think since we last left off, I did manage to put a new hammer, fit a new Ed Brown hammer in there and redid the hammer hooks or faced them off, refaced the sear. And I think I changed out the disconnector, so I was able to properly get that all set up and end up having a much better trigger pull than where we started. It's slowly chunking along. I got the next series, you know, it's in post-production. I'm just kind of adding as I go, but honestly, I've not had enough time to properly actually do much on the gun besides that. So it's chugging along, but I have not forgotten. It's still here. Next, got the Glock 19X, and this is my carry gun. Absolutely love it, and I've just left it factory. The only change I've made to it is just adding on that monster grip portion that comes with it, and there's your difference right there with and without it. This is my buddy's 19X, and I might try to take advantage of the time to be able to do a 19X review, because I did a quick look video. You've seen it in the channel here and there, but I might actually be able to do a full feature length review if you guys are interested in that, especially having two guns that I could possibly do different groups and at least have a sample size of two. But the bottom line up front on the 19X is I absolutely love it. It's my carry gun, and it's just great. I have no complaints. I've just left it original. The trigger is a little bit more to be desired, but that's me being a trigger snog coming off of 1911s and just kind of. But I would not, for carry and defense, I would not change any of that. Maybe the sights, and then maybe the grip panels if you want to do that. But I've been very happy with the 19X. So I might take an opportunity to do a full length with a sample size of two if you guys would be interested in that. Next, I got these guns here. My old school 1911 Springfield. This is the custom mil-spec. And boy, has this gun had a lot of changes over time. This gun has, I've refinished it three times, changed the sights three times. All kinds of parts have come in and out. The only thing that's still Springfield is the frame slide and barrel. Literally everything else is Ed Brown, Nighthawk, Wilson. This is the gun that I kind of cut my teeth on and learned everything that I do, and kind of got all my jigs and tools and everything I need to work on them. So this gun, it was my carry gun for years, and kind of a little mini thing too, is Surefire does make these rail mounts that go on, at least for the Beretta and the 1911, and they probably make some others. I think it's discontinued, but you can still kind of get them online. But that's a little mini side note, that these Surefire rail mounts that you can retrofit onto a Beretta or a 1911, absolutely love them, because it'll take your standard 1911 with no rail, and you can just quickly pop this on. You can set it for tension, adjust it, and all of a sudden you have a light mount that's very successful. And the same thing goes for the Beretta, the MR11 mount from them. And it's kind of an interesting deal how this works, but both of them are very secure. Been very happy with them. So I might end up doing a review, since I have two of them now. I've had the 1911 rail for years now. But it's here because I'm doing the Black Hawk Omnivore review. Jackal 19X requested that. So after this, I'm going to get working on that, try to put it out. But been very happy with this. Long story short, this holster mounts on the light. It does not mount to any specific gun. So at least these four guns you see on the table, and then this one, if I put the Surefire mount on it, all of those guns are going to work in this holster. So stand by for the review on that. That's going to be coming out shortly. But I'm going to keep you guys updated on that. Next reminder is I do have the M&P 1522. I did a quick look video about a year ago on it when I first got it. And after I've had it for a year, I don't even know how many rounds I've shot out of it. Just so many bricks. And I'm happy to report that the gun is still totally functional, totally reliable, and it's actually holding some pretty good groups still. Nothing has changed. So big super thumbs up on this if you're looking for a reliable, quality AR-15 dedicated 22 kind of trainer recreation rifle. Definitely highly recommended. Got that Vortex Strikefire 2 on top. Definitely an affordable, nice red dot. I know dudes are putting this on their ARs and stuff like that. I just threw it on this 22. And I've been having success with it. Looks like, let's see. My last zero was 100 yards, Federal 36 grain. I always like to put, if it's zero to a certain type of ammo, I always put that on there. But highly recommended, definitely love it. And if you guys want a feature length, I think it's about time, so just let me know. Let's see, next reminder I have, without anything falling over, is the M16A4 Build Project rifle. And I'm happy to report, last where we left off, the ACOG was having problems holding zero. and I sent it back. I talked to Trigicon, sent it back. They were super cool about it, paid for shipping and everything, 3-week turnaround. And I'm happy to report I mounted it back on and everything's perfect. It's working how it should. For those not up to speed, this is just a standard 20-inch M16A4-ish kind of build that I wanted to do. Not a super precision Mark 12 match SPR kind of rifle, but it's just a basic M16 build. But yes, I'm happy to report that the ACOG is back in action and it's perfectly fine. And I'm getting a little tangled up down here. Okay, some basic groups real quick that I was able to do the other day on it. Let's see, final group, see if I can get some contrast here. So my final 5-shot group was this. I had one flyer and I ended up keeping that zero. Let's see, without the flyer, we're coming a little bit over an inch, and with the flyer, it's about not 3.5 yet. The rest of this, I was kind of messing around, fine-tuning it, getting it ready to go, and then I ended up doing sort of a practical test, and I had this group size here on this spray-painted silhouette target here. You guys know, if you've been following me for a while, you know I'm all about the quick and easy range stuff. Let's see, this 5-shot group is just over 2 inches. I made some adjustments, and then finally I was holding right here and ended up getting this 5-shot group coming in at just over 2 inches, or actually maybe a little more, 2.5. And then I tested out some green tip just to confirm why I don't really prefer green tip, and this is kind of what we got. So again, this is not a Mark 12, it's not an SPR, precision match, NRA high power service rifle kind of build. This is just a standard basic issue M16A4 build, and that's exactly what I expect it to do. You know, 1.5 to 2.5 inches, I'm happy. Next, let's talk about the Ishapore 2A1 Lee Enfield. You might notice it looks a little different. Went ahead, I took it all the way apart, and I used some crud cutter. You could see that back here in the video. Great stuff. It's not harmful, doesn't have crazy chemicals and stuff. Does a really great job of cleaning out those stocks, getting all that crud and oil and stuff out. Still has a lot of oil soaked in these stocks, but they're definitely a lot cleaner. Didn't do any refinishing, didn't do anything crazy on it. Just went ahead and refinished it. Or not refinished, I just cleaned it out. But I did get all that cheap black nasty paint just off of the metal. And I do have some videos on this if you want to check it out in detail, but the rifle itself is good to go and definitely appreciate it in its natural original metal finish as opposed to that Field Expedient cheap hand applied black paint. And you can actually see the markings now. That's cool. So anyway, that's kind of a long story short of what is going on and where things have kind of been, what has been taking place. And I do want to get to a place someday where I'm more reliable, more current. I'd love to be doing 2 reliable uploads a week where you just know that night of the week you're just going to get something from me. Work has been crazy. It's only going to get worse, at least for the short term, but there is going to be a little bit of momentary pause after that. So I do want to get to a place where I'm more current, more reliable, posting more stuff all the time. Unfortunately, I'm not able to be there yet, but I just want to give you guys an update on what is going on. And certainly if there's any videos that you guys want front loaded or any videos that you guys want sooner rather than later, let me know. I could start prioritizing all of these. You kind of see where my mind is at and what I want to do. Let me know in the comments. Definitely next thing coming up is the Omnivore review as per request. So I do like to, you might find me in the comments trying to work with you guys, talk and see what you guys want. Anyway, thanks for hanging with it. I do appreciate you guys subscribing and watching and commenting. I'm just glad to have you guys. I just wish I could be more current with you guys and more reliable with the uploads. But anyway, thank you for watching, and let me know what you want.